good afternoon and a great welcome to all of you, girls and two boys who are the leaders in our schools. It's lovely to see you. You are head girls, head boys, house captains, head girl teams. You're the brightest and best of GDST's six forms, and it's fantastic to have you all here. And a huge welcome to all the staff from across the GDST and from Royal High School who have given up their weekends to be with you for what we hope will be two very exciting days. There are three things we want you to get out of this weekend. First of all, we want you to get to know leaders from across our schools, mix in together and work on teams with other sixth formers who you've never met before. Secondly, we want you to learn about leadership, what it means and how to build leadership qualities in yourself. And thirdly, we want you to have a lot of fun. Over the weekend, you will work at high pressure and high speed on a task that we hope will stretch and challenge you in lots of different ways. We're lucky enough to have four major national charities with us today: Breakthrough Breast Cancer, WizKids, Click Sergeant and CamFed. And you will be divided up and mixed in with girls from all the different schools and into teams, and each team will represent a project team from an international marketing and events agency, and your job will be to put together for your chosen charity, and you'll be divided up among the four, an incredible fundraising event, completely new and original, which will raise your charity's profile, bring in shed loads of money, and be a real sort of marker in that charity's history. The campaign you come up with will be pitched to the charity and to our judges on Sunday morning, and there will be a number of awards for the best campaigns. We've chosen this particular challenge for you because it's very relevant to a lot of things you do in your schools. A lot of you are involved in fundraising, a lot of you have been involved throughout your school career in raising money for charities, but you also, as head girls, you have to speak publicly, you have to speak at prize givings, you often have to market your school when you take prospective parents round. You're effectively pitching the school to the parents. You are the public face of the school in so many ways. And so what we hope one of the things this weekend will give you is some key skills that will be really useful to you in the year ahead when you are leaders of your school. Obviously, it's really important what you come up with, and your campaign, the presentation of campaigns on Sunday morning, is very exciting and a lot of fun and highly competitive. But the real point of the weekend is not so much that end campaign that you come up with. It's very much the journey of the next 2 days and what you will learn there on the way. In a very short time, you have to learn the strengths of your team. You have to allocate roles, you have to get things achieved, and all this is against the clock. Now, I was here last year, and I won't say there were tears before bedtime, but as the deadline approached at 7 o'clock in the evening, it got very, very, very frantic indeed. So it's exciting and it's stressful, and you'll learn a lot about yourself from that process. So why does leadership matter, and why do GDST spend so much time thinking about leadership and trying to build leadership skills in its pupils? Well, I guess the four remarkable women who founded GDST 140 years ago were all real leaders. They had courage and commitment, and they stuck their necks out to start a whole chain of girls' schools when very, very few opportunities for education for girls existed. They were visionary, they had energy, and they had drive. But that 140 years has been a tough old journey for young women. And as part of our anniversary celebrations, we published a little booklet called Then and Now, which was a history of both the GDST and what had happened to women in those years. And one of the things that really shocked me was how recently really extraordinary disadvantages existed for women. In the 1970s, when I began work, if you were aspiring young woman employee at the Foreign Office and you got married, you had to leave your job. That was in the 1970s. And although we have had our first woman Prime Minister in Margaret Thatcher, our first woman CEO of a FTSE 100 company in Marjorie Scardino, for whom I used to work. Actually, there is still a long way to go for young women in organisations today. We often talk to some of our brilliant young alumni who are perhaps in their late 20s, early 30s, vice president of Goldman Sachs or the global HR director for Unilever. And all these women say that in some way their gender still was a barrier for them, a barrier they'd overcome, but it was still there. And I think, you know, obviously I feel I have to kind of say sorry to the two young men in our audience, because I'm talking a lot about young women, but actually I would say it's very challenging for any young person today to rise up in an organisation, and knowing what skills you need to do that is really important. Some of you may say, well, leadership sounds very kind of businessy, and you know, I don't want to work in a business, I want to be a vet or a sports person or an aid worker or a lawyer or an academic. So why is it relevant to me? Well, one of the things this weekend I think is going to give you experience of is something I call PUP, performance under pressure. You're going to have to do some really demanding tasks against the clock with a team of people you don't know. Now, if you're a young barrister appearing before a testy old judge for the first time, or you're a young doctor having perhaps to do a particular procedure that you've never done before, while your consultant looks on, or you're a UN aid worker going into territory you've never been in before, or a young advertising executive, you are going to have to perform under pressure in the kind of jobs that all of you, with your fantastic education and your brilliant brains and your great personalities, are going to do. There's going to be a lot of pressure. And what we hope this weekend will show you is what will help you get through when you're under that kind of pressure and those sort of time pressures. And I'd say there are three things that will really help. One is self-knowledge. The better you understand yourself, the better you're going to be able to work with other people and get to the destination you want. And I think if we look at some examples of people who perhaps were universally acknowledged not to have been terribly good leaders, for instance, looking at politics, say William Hague and Gordon Brown, just to be completely even-handed, I think people would say that some of their, you know, William Hague putting on a baseball cap to get down with the kids, or Gordon Brown hurling computers at his office staff, you'd say there wasn't a lot of self-knowledge there. And maybe if they had understood each other better, they would have done better. Because when you're a leader, you have to make decisions fast, based on evidence which may not be complete, and you need to get those decisions right. And if you know yourself, then things like fear, irritation, anger, you can put those out of the picture and really focus on what it is you're supposed to be doing. So this weekend, I hope you'll find out a lot about yourself and a lot about other people. I think energy is really important in leadership. Being a leader in any kind of role is very hard work. And one of the things I've always noticed when I've met leaders, whether political leaders or business leaders, is they tend to radiate energy. They may have just stepped off a 15-hour flight and be going straight into a crucial meeting with their brief in their hand, but they're still up for it. But one of the things leaders also know is that they have to, in order to have that energy, you have to replenish yourself. You have to get enough sleep, enough food, enough drink. One of the things we can't promise the sleep, but we're going to be very careful that you get plenty of food and drink this weekend to fuel the activity that you're going to go through. And then finally, vision. Leading is all about getting an organisation to go from A to B. Now that sounds incredibly simple and obvious, but it can be surprisingly difficult. People don't necessarily want to go to B. They say, well, why don't we go to C instead? Well, why do we have to go anywhere at all? I just don't have the energy for the journey. So the vision, your picture of where you want to get to as a leader, is what again is going to take those people with you on the journey to the destination. You've got to be able to paint that glorious destination they'll get to if only they all buy into your vision. And it'll be very interesting this weekend, because you may find on your teams you have four or five different visions. It'll be very interesting to see which vision wins. But it's that ability to paint a clear, distinctive picture of where you, of the destination, that makes such a difference. And keeping your team focused on that destination, constantly working towards it, is crucial. And your vision for your winning charity is going to be what drives you through the challenges of this weekend. Now, I know that because you're all GDST girls and boys, you will have in spades those qualities we call our four C's, which are commitment, courage, composure, and confidence. And you will need those in spades this weekend. But I think if you can marry those to self-knowledge, to energy, and to vision, then you will be able to perform under pressure. And that is going to be a quality that will be with you for life. And it's a quality that's going to be important whether you work in business, whether you work in government, whether you work in a charity, whether you work in sport. All of those will have situations where you feel that problems are coming at you like aliens in a Space Invaders game. And that calm, commitment, courage will enable you to master them. Now, we're enormously lucky to have two fantastic speakers with us today. It's a huge privilege to welcome Camilla Mangalid and Anne Daniels to speak to you about their experiences of their lives and of leadership positions. Camilla hardly needs any introduction. I think you all recognise her. We had staff coming up to shake your hand as you walked down the corridors of Royal High today. Her wonderful charity, Kids Company, has raised over £40 million and helped thousands and thousands of children in the most difficult, disadvantaged and frightening situations in inner cities. She's an icon. She's a person that I think all of us have admired for many years, and it's going to be a great privilege to hear her talk.